Who's with you right with now? Us?
Okay, well, look, I was going to say, we're talking about Ethians in this show, so I've got someone who was desperate to meet you.
Oh,
this
my
is my
God.
Daughter. And I'm going to say, the way that she looks at me sometimes, guys, I'm like, are you a person?
An Ethian.
Oh, she's for sure an Ethian.
She's an Ethian.
I can see it in the eyes.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought she would, I know, I was like, puppies always win. I mean, how can you not? And I love the concept of the Ethians in this show. I mean, we could get into the deep side of it of like, you know, they stand for people that have been ostracized. But really, what I love about it is that it adds this element to this brilliant show. And I guess my first question is because you don't get to choose what you are as an Ethian, so I would love you to choose each other's animals. And that's what you think the other would be.
I'm going to say.
Yeah.
You. No, I'm not going to go off the rails here.
Yeah.
Dolphin.
A dolphin?
Yes.
I love that.
He has dolphin.
Yeah.
That's good. I'm a terrible.
I was going to say.
It would be nice to turn into a dolphin when I go near water.
Because
in my human form, I'm not great in water.
Yeah, the second that you transform.
Okay. Yeah, I could jump in as a human. Turn dolphin.
Yeah.
And that'd be quite. You would be. I'm trying to think. Do you know what we've? I think sometimes you're like you actually have like a sort of big cat energy. Big cat. Sort of like I think it's today as well with like your glam and there's definitely the big eyes.
Yeah.
And there's sort of like, there's something slinky going on that I think is quite big catty.
All right. I see you. It's a rather sexy gazelle.
Oh,
thank you. Gazelle energy.
You.
Here we go.
As a cobra.
Oh, for goodness sake.
No, I just. Wow. Just saying anything that comes into my head.
So you've gone for snake.
I like snakes.
Nobody likes snakes. Yeah. I said sexy gazelle.
But you know, we can't both go and you're a sexy.
But you can. Yeah. There's sexy. Plenty of room between sexy gazelle and cobra.
It could have gone horribly wrong.
A mole or a shrew.
A buffalo.
A dormouse. Anything.
Do you know what? I was immediately obsessed with this show, but for all the reasons I didn't think that I would be. So I knew there was a bit of fantasy. I knew that it was like an alternate history style show, but you guys had me on the floor with the comedy, like the one-liners, it's absolutely brilliant. And I think Australians in particular are going to love this. Some of my favorite one-liners were things like not today, Satan, Margaret, you're 10, beer only, busting yeah. for a Waz. I mean, do you have any favorites that you can recall in the series?
There's one that was an improvisation by Rob Brydon, who plays Dudley, that is actually kind of hard to hear because the camera moves away and you just hear him in the background say, the thing about when you buy a tapestry, it's not for you, it's for your ancestors. And I think that's my fourth line.
That was in that scene as I walk away talking about the tapestries and stuff. Yeah. Well, but they were very open.
Rob's a little bit of a genius like that.
No, I'm a nuisance like that. And they
his mind doesn't stop working. He just can't. So it just pours out of him.
I think if you spoke to my wife, she would say that my mind often stops working.
You just think these things.
Well, it's just a thing like...
I don't think you think about it.
To be serious, that's just how my mind is.
Exactly.
And other people have a mind. And hit a perfect tennis swing, or other people have a mind, you know, like yours, that can say that their lovely dear friend is a cobra.
A couple of things I wanted to say was congratulations on Tribeca. I mean, you must just be incredibly, incredibly proud. It was, I truly hope that, you know, audiences love it as much as what I did. But I also would love to say, Edward, do you feel that you are giving us like Regency period Harry Styles?
Do you know what? It's so great that you mentioned that because that was in the character breakdown.
Yes!
It said, Guildford Dudley, a Tudor Harry Styles / Mick Jagger. And it's exactly that.
Let us take a moment to reassure our viewers that there is no such thing as love at first sight, but lust at first sight. Oh yes, totally a thing.
I mean, they, you know, I would imagine they approached Harry, but he was busy, so couldn't play it. So I'm always happy to pick up his scraps. I think it was definitely someone who they had in mind.
You did a wonderful job at it. My final question for you would be, what do you think Aussies in particular are going to love about this show when it does arrive on our platforms and we get to see it? Because I know what I feel. I feel like it's the comedy that's going to grab us in. But is there something that you think that, you know, from your creation of the entire series that we're going to particularly love?
The element of fantasy is so kind of unexpected and will surprise people. And the show has so many different genres kind of tied in this bow. And the fantasy element that is actually very strong in the whole core of this, I think, will be exciting and surprising.
Yeah. And maybe next season, if there is one, we can have an Ethian koala just for you guys.
Yes. Oh, can I volunteer as tribute? Because that would just be absolutely...
Perfect.
Cast.
Yeah. Just have your people talk to my people. Lady Frances Grey, who is obviously, the motherly figure. And you know what I loved about this is that your character is not that kind of like bumbling mother that's only worried about, you know, marrying her daughter off. I would go so far as to say I feel like your character is the smartest out of all of them because she is moving the pieces into play. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I think she's got an overview. And Jen and Meredith, who write it, they say they both got very strong mothers and they roar with laughter as they write down these things and they make these jokes. So they want, from the writer's point of view, they want Frances to be a step ahead of the game. They want her to be sort of, you know, like a villainous character in a way, but they think it's funny if she's always right. It is
quite funny. Absolutely.
There's almost like the anti-heroine, she's somehow right. In fact, even though she's a nightmare and a controlling.
But my favorite part is how much of that you portray without really saying anything at all. Like, it's almost like we can see as the, you know, as the viewer what's happening in this situation and your character almost, and you can see the cogs going and she thinks and she's like, aha, I can manipulate this situation.
Well,
it's just
so really
fantastic.
Fun, those shots where they're just like,
so good.
And we're going to watch the whole scene and it makes you laugh. The stupid you're like shot by or you've realized. That's never going to happen.
Now, Rob, let's talk about your character. I love a man who loves a bit of jewellery. I mean, I just, you know, a beautiful earring. I researched it. I found out that that was what Lord Dudley was into. I mean, have you yourself, did you get your ear pierced for it or was it like?
No. You're mistaking me with a more committed actor. No, I didn't. No, they would just clip it on. Of course, this is just the jewellery that you can see.
But did Lord Dudley, in the pictures of him, does he have an earring?
I don't know.
Oh, he doesn't even know that.
Yeah, I had a look at some paintings. You can't see it, but it is very well documented that he used to love a pearl. Hey, I've already said to the guys before that we want an Ethian koala and that I have put my hand up to play it in the next season, if that's all right with you.
Yeah. I think an Ethian koala would be a lovely idea, though you do have to be careful with koalas.
As to what's in your pouch.
Are you well? Yes. You know what you can get from a koala, don't you?
Yes. Oh, here we go.
Things that you are not aware of. For somebody who's very smart.
Do you want me to break the news to Anna or would you like to do it?
Please tell me. You tell me.
Koalas have chlamydia.
Oh.
Hi, everybody. Enjoy your breakfast.
Oh, really? What a terrible
thing. I didn't know that.
I know. I'm so sorry. Hey, I feel like maybe we should finish up there. This show is one of my favorites that I have seen all year. It is delightfully funny and it has so many elements in it that I absolutely loved. And I think Australians, I mean, Rob, you know what Aussies are like. You've met all of us before. You've met the sarcastic Aussie and the silly Aussie. I think we're going to love it. I mean, is there anything you'd like to say finally to Aussie audiences before they get to see it on their screen?
Oh, Rob said, I love Australians. I can't wait to speak to the Australians.
I do. I've toured Australia. I've a few times I've filmed in Australia.
You're his people.
Yes. Oh, listen, I could.
Yes, we love him.
Where are you speaking to us from?
I am smack in the middle of Sydney right now.
I love Sydney. I adore Sydney. Oh, sweet Lord, I miss it. I hope the Australians love My Lady Jane on Prime Video because
yes.
It would give me another excuse to come and visit again.
Please do. We would love to see you. Thank you both for your time. I really appreciate it.
Thanks very much.